Good morning, coffee drinkers. There was a few comments on the vlog a couple of days ago when I was asking about the length of the vlogs, you know, the content, all that kind of stuff. And it's a bit of a mixed bag. Kind of the 10 to 20 minute mark seems to be doing the trick, so I will attempt to stay right around there. And so people were saying they like the variation in the vlog, not just kind of monosyllabic, like the whole day. So I am gonna try and do a better job of taking the camera with me everywhere. And as always, my day generally starts out with physical exercise. So that's where I am on the way to right now, on the way to the club. And today I'm gonna hit first on core and then train in the gym. Most times I do the gym first, but I'll give you guys a little bit of a look inside that process right now. So no matter what I'm doing at the club, normally I stop by court three to see my coach first, see what's going on. Looking on the tan today?
As long as it's not so strong.
Having said there's almost something always interesting going on court three, it's normally more interesting than the tan lines of the great Christian Strucker.
Okay, and now look, 3,600 dog elixir.
Yeah. I got a lot of work to do on my my clashing situation. First order of business, do battle with this knucklehead. You might recognize Louis from such films as The Paradiddle Part 2. 2 hours and 45 minutes. I had two match points, and this clown came back and won 6 in the third. For anyone who knows about tennis, you know how much of a pain in the ass 6 in the third is. Means it was a really good match, but it also sucks to lose 6 in the third. All right, time for the gym. Okay, feeling pretty good. Did like a 30 minute recovery with PhysioFix and creatine. Just took some pressure off the legs and rested for a little bit. So I feel pretty recovered even after a 2 hour and 45 minute match. Now I'm gonna try and get like 45 minutes to an hour. Really gonna go after the legs today. Hopefully I can remember to leave the camera on, show you a few of these crazy exercises that I do in the gym pretty much every day.
important part of the day, the workout, but the day in general, even if I don't work out, vibrating foam roller. Turns your muscles to butter. Gotta get stretching. I've been traveling so much recently, I feel super unflexible. But now I'm home for the month, hoping to change all of that. And regardless of whether I'm working out, I'm trying to do this every day. So stiff. All right, that's it, 4 hours today. 4 hours, tennis and gym. That's a good day. Now I'm pretty exhausted, need to refuel, go home and eat. Maybe even take a nap for a half hour, a little power nap, and then get to practicing. All right, so I'm home working on the soundtrack to the vlog. Picked out a groove I liked, picked out a topper, really simple. It's a little hi-hat thing to go over the groove. No harmony yet, but I'm kind of hearing a couple of things already in my head. In fact, I think I'm gonna go straight to Keyscape and try some things I haven't tried before. There are a whole bunch of combinations within Keyscape, like some duos where they've matched two instruments together. And I've been watching a little YouTube, watching some of their artists, you know, play around with different sounds. And I think there's gonna be some cool stuff to find in there. Ooh. That's not a bad start. I just chose it's not actually the first one, it's the third one. Cella chimes, I've got a celeste and a chime. Already, I kind of like this theme. I don't know if it's going to go with the groove, though. That's the only thing. Let's see. That's not bad. Maybe I'll delay it a little bit down to baby. Okay, we might be onto something. One, two, three, and. I don't know how long, this is how it works. I don't know how long that idea is gonna stick around, but it's not a bad first idea. Maybe I'm gonna change the sound and experiment with it. But what I am gonna do is make sure I have the right length of loop, and I'm gonna record it. Two, three, and. This one's really dramatic. Woo! It's on some Hans Zimmer type stuff. Oh, still in preview mode, so it's breaking up a little bit. Okay, here we go. A little low for that voicing. Still a little low. I do also want to point out the simplicity of this idea. And again, the same thing I use on the bass when I'm working with melodies and chords and trying to start, you know, come up with a composition. We're literally just using roots and tenths. That's all it is. But I'm not sure about this sound. Let's see. Actually, maybe in the lower end. Maybe I can find a way to play fifths. Let's try it. Let's put that down. Maybe I'll turn it down a little bit in the mix and that will become a layer. Now we have some juice in the drums a little bit. I'm gonna back those off, but that feels a lot better with that compressor in there. And so it goes. And what you will already have heard in the intro of today's vlog is the finished product. This is how I spend quite a large portion of my day, being creative and writing and recording and doing all that kind of stuff. And having the vlog as like a creative outlet to write new tracks and find new melodies is pretty awesome. Very important part of the day right now.
Cut it, thank you very much.
So don't get me wrong, I really like to cook. I cook all the time. Chelsea will testify to that. But sometimes when it's a long day and I've got a ton of stuff I need to get done, there is no way of escaping the delivery situation, which is pretty plentiful in LA, I gotta say. And I have found one place which is pretty legit with the Indian food. And it's at times like this where, yes, I completely lose touch with reality and forget how spoiled I am living in Southern California and living in such a big city like LA, where everything is pretty readily available. Refuel from the day. Today was a big one. I don't normally play a nearly 3 hour match. Normally I hit for like 90 minutes and train and then get in the gym and do 90 minutes or whatever, or an hour or something. It's never normally quite that intense or that long in terms of the match play. So today was a little unique in that sense, and a great change up, you know, a great thing to do. I'm not mad that it went down that way at all. I mean, I'm not happy that I lost, but definitely not mad about the fact that we got to play best of three and went the distance. All right, I'm switching off the camera. I'm shutting down everything, eating the food, and we'll binge some some TV or something. That's what I do.
Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers, and conundrums. Did you know, for example, 6% of drivers deliberately swerve to kill animals? Now, that might sound terrible, but roadkill is how the people of Norfolk get their protein.
It's about 7:15. These are the first notes I'm playing on the bass, just tuning up here, about to start my practice session. Really trying to pace the day well today. Away, I've found something that I want to work on. I've been putting together the kind of the sequence of how the exercises are going to go in the new chord book, starting with the very simple, let me take the delay off for a second, the simple root and tenths exercise. I can afford myself a tiny bit more volume today. I shouldn't try and do it that fast, that soon after picking up the bass. But just getting from that all the way to exercises like this, and then exercises like that, and then putting in a moving pass. I'm just working on the arc of kind of the fundamentals of voicing chords with the left hand on the bass. That's where I'm at with the book this week. It is not an easy process. It is not a fast process, and it's one I'm taking great care with, because I hope it's something that's going to be around for a very long time, and something that will be a really useful reference tool for you if you get the book. But right there, as I started playing, one of the exercises is suspension and resolution from the 4 to the 3.
diatonically speaking, in a major scale. And I kind of happened to be playing, what was I playing? Something like that. Just messing around just now. And what I want to be able to do is have two suspensions and resolutions in each voicing. So instead of going from the 4 to the 3 in the melody on D minor, I also want to be able to go from the flat 6 to the 5. So I've got and all over the root. So those two different voicings, and to be able to do that throughout the instrument in major, minor, diminished, dominant, just every possible combination. Great when little things like that come up. Great that I have the camera running, because then I can remember them. The two suspensions is not something I've really worked on ever before at all, so that's something that I definitely need to give some careful practice with. Whatever, that will all be in the book. This is just me kind of thinking out loud and practicing. So that's the day. That's what happens. Like that, I hope that gave a good arc of what the day was all about. It's not obviously not over yet. It's only 7:30. I'm going to carry on practicing for at least another hour, I think, and then edit the vlog and then hopefully have the energy to do something else. It's been a pretty exhausting day so far, but that's kind of the arc. This is probably like the minimum that goes into every day. You know, still this evening I have to do flights and I have to do many, many more emails for the Last Minute World Tour. Don't forget to check the website. We have new dates added to the Last Minute World Tour for the next leg, which is next month, May. I think we start the 7th in Istanbul. So we're going Istanbul, Cyprus. We've got dates in Germany, in Belgium, in France, in Spain, in the Czech Republic, in Poland, in Slovakia. I mean, it's a pretty diverse European tour. Probably one of the most diverse European legs of a tour I've ever done, I think. Very varied amount of countries. Now I have to shut off the camera, finish practicing, edit the vlog, get it uploaded, and then do a ton of email and book flights to get to Europe next month. So today's vlog is done. I will see you guys tomorrow.